Hello class, and welcome to our very exciting course, Financial Management. And I'm your instructor, Dr. Jamal. So okay, today we are having a new chapter named Financial Statement Analysis. In our previous lecture, we talked about understanding of financial statements. So humne apne pichle lecture mein how financial statements can be viewed sorry about that humne wo sara dekha ki income statement mein koi cheeze agar badh rahi hai to uska kya matlab hai balance sheet mein agar hum comparison kare past year ke data ke sath current year ke data ke sath to kaun kaun si possible positive and negative points ho sakte hain all right so this lecture is all about now in detailed analysis I would say याद होगा आपको हमने एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ दिस लेक्चर इट दिस कोर्स वी टॉक्ड अबाउट देयर आर सम रेशियोज इन व्हिच टेल्स अस दैट हाउ मच परचेजिंग ऑफ द एसेट्स कैन कंट्रीब्यूट टू द ओवरऑल प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न दैट सो लेट्स जस्ट dive deep into the world of financial analysis. Here we go. So our today's agenda is that we are learning some key ratios. So I want you guys to please remember those ratios. Some ratios are quite obvious. So kuch bahut zyada easy hain jo ki unke naam se bhi aap unko jo hai na unka formula yaad kar sakte hain but kuch formulas jo hain wo aapko yaad karne padenge. Don't worry about that. I would be uploading a sheet full of formulas. So I have done a great work for you guys and it's free so you can just take that as a note or you can just print it out from your office and you can remember it okay so we'll talk about some key ratios and we'll do some analysis and we'll talk about what these ratio tells about whether it's a good sign or whether it's a bad sign or whether we are doing okay And then we talk about some limitations of ratios at the end. So I hope today we'll cover this whole chapter. If not, then at least my, agenda is that we at least cover half of the chapter. Okay? So let's move on. So let me set aside the controls here so that I can read as well. Here we go. So after this chapter, basically these are the learning objective. You will be able to, or you should be able to understand all these queries and you can answer that accordingly. So let's just start it. Financial statement analysis. So what do we mean by that? First of all, the word started from financial statement. So how many statements we have? We talked about there are
four statements.
Income statement,
balance sheet,
retained earning,
income statement, and cash flows.
Cash flows.
Right. Well done, guys. That's it that you remember. So retained earning. So and. It does have a liquidity order, or you can say the order as well. First, we make income statement. From income statement, we calculate net income. Net income is used to calculate retained earning. Retained earning is used in balance sheet, and from balance sheet, you can make cash flow statement. So there is an order as well. So we are not following the order right now because this chapter is all about analysis. So the next thing we will talk about. A possible framework for analysis, and then we talk about balance sheet ratios, income statement ratios, mixed ratios means some like ratio is numerator over denominator. This will come from income statement and this will come from balance sheet or this is coming from balance sheet or this is coming from income statement so we call this mixed ratio okay and then we talk about trend analysis and at the end we'll talk about common size and index analysis so let's just go one by one. So the most important or primary statements are income statement and balance sheet. And we talk about this basket wonders balance sheet in detail in our last lecture, right? We talked about how much is how much company own, how much company is owed by outsiders, total liability, current plus long-term liability, how much is the insider's claim, it's the total equity. Yes, Maman. It's because of
Numan tumhari entry kharab kar rahi hai sara kuch. Entry apni nikalo.
I think it's your entry, Numan. Oh, where is Numan now? Gone? Okay.
Mubeen.
Okay, now I think it's good. Yes, Numan. Which question tha?
मैं सर हैंसफ्री के कह रहा था, अब शायद मैं अपनी चेंज करता हूँ. मुझे ना आवाज ठीक से आपकी ऑडिबल नहीं थी, तो मैं इसलिए कंफर्म कर रहा था.
ओके ओके ओके, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. ओके, यू डोंट नीड टू रेज हैंड, यू कैन जस्ट जंप इनटू द डिस्कशन. दैट इज आई थिंक मोर लाइवली वन. ओके,
राइट सर, राइट, थैंक यू.
यू कैन जस्ट से दैट ओके सर और मिस्टर जमाल, आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन, सो प्लीज कैन यू गो बैक टू स्लाइड ब्ला 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 एंड यू नो रिपीट दैट वन. I don't mind. Okay. Okay.
Right, sir.
So the primary statements are balance sheet and income statement. Balance sheet looks like first we have current assets and then we have long-term assets. So we have total assets. And then, so this is the account format in which left-hand side is the assets and right-hand side is liabilities plus owner's equity. So first we write down current liabilities and then long-term liabilities, and then we write shareholder equity. All right, at the end, the balance sheet equation does hold asset is equal to liabilities plus owner's equity. All right, and then we discussed income statement, which is multi-step income statement, which starts from sales means net sales, which means you less all the discount, all the sale return, any kind of benefit that you give to customers. So that's why there is a net here. So sales minus cost of goods sold, we have gross profit. And from gross profit, you less all the selling, general, admin expenses, you get EBIT. Remember, the other name of EBIT is operating income.
Sir, earning before tax.
Yes, but in the other name is operating income, earning before interest and taxes, EBIT. And then we less interest and taxes, we get net income. From net income, you less dividend. It means that part of income you are not distributing to the shareholders, you are retaining in the business. So we call this retained earning, which means current this year addition to retained earning. All right, so normally the income statement ends here up to net income. We don't write down the dividends and all those stuff, but this is just if you want to write it down, okay, you can write it down because the name states income statement. So the last point is finding out the income, which is net income. So in multi-step model, we talked about there are three kinds of profit: gross profit, operating profit, which is EBIT, and then at the end, net income or earning after tax. It's the same. Don't get confused. So are we good to go to move forward? Now, the real deal here. So if you are analyzing the financial statements, first of all, you should follow some kind of framework. So hame sabse pehle jo framework use karna hai wo kaun sa karna hai, analysis of funds needed of the firm. Hum analysis kyun karenge kisi company ka? Hum pehla answer ye karenge ki jo funds hame owners de rahe hain, shares, shareholder jo hame paise de rahe hain. Dusra jo hame outsiders, jo creditors hame paisa de rahe hain, hame kitna paisa chahiye, kahan se aayega, kya koi any seasonal component hai? Jaise aap dekhe garment industry mein, right now winter season is going to start, to hame ab kis mein investment karni chahiye, garam stuff mein ya hame abhi taiyari karni chahiye summer ki?
Garam winter.
Winter is already, right? As a company, you should start selling products way before winter is coming. Way before winter started. All right? Now this is a season. आपने जो stock बनाया होगा वो आप अपनी push strategy से इसको sell करना start करेंगे. All right? तो इसे बोलेंगे seasonal component. Trend component से क्या मुराद है? अच्छा यार ये महीना चल रहा है नवंबर का, पिछले साल हमारे पास नवंबर में स्टॉक कितना था, हमने क्या कोई नया ऑर्डर तो नहीं प्लेस किया था, क्या रॉ मटेरियल हमारे पास 10% था, 20% था, अब कितना रह गया? तो आप बेस्ड ऑन योर प्रीवियस ईयर नीड यू फोरकास्ट नाउ, इसे बोलेंगे ट्रेंड. सो आर वी क्लियर अबाउट ट्रेंड एंड सीजनल कंपोनेंट एवरीवन? उमर?
यस सर.
Numan, Myra, Rimsha.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. अब हम इसको एनालाइज कैसे करेंगे? इस सीजनल कंपोनेंट को और ट्रेंड कंपोनेंट को हम एनालाइज करने के लिए क्या करेंगे? हम स्टेटमेंट्स को यूज करेंगे, और स्पेशली कौन सी स्टेटमेंट्स को? कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट. कैश फ्लो ईयरली एंड पे भी बना सकते हो आप, और आप मंथली कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट भी बना सकते हो. राइट right? लेकिन हाँ, पब्लिश आप जो लॉ कहते हैं वो रिक्वायर क्या है कि आप ईयरली पब्लिश एटलीस्ट वन टाइम लाजमी करेंगे. राइट जैसे ईयरली इनकम स्टेटमेंट, ईयरली बैलेंस शीट, ईयरली कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट, ईयरली रिटेन अर्निंग स्टेटमेंट.